I'm a PhD student at the University of Massachusetts. This is a joint work with Rosie Rahimi and my advisor, James Allen. And the title of the paper is Parent Discrimination Value for Cross Language Information to All. As an introduction, let's see an example of the CLRR task. In the CLRR task, consider that we have a query in the source language. And this query has four translation. Each translation has a four field translation and one distinguishing value. And the main question is that how we can compute the distinguishing value of the query term in the source language based on this information that we have in the target language. In this paper, we address two research questions. The first is that do the cross-language retrieval models correctly estimate the difference between the distribution power of query terms? And the second one is that is there a better way to estimate the distribution value of query term in the CLRR? A widely used model in the CLRR, which is a state of the art also, is probabilistic structured query. And in the PSQ, the term frequency of the query term in the document can be computed by summation over multiplication between the probability of translation and the term frequency of the term in the document. In the same way, in the second formula, we can compute the document frequency of the query by a summation or a multiplication between the probability of the probability of translation and document frequency of the translation. And finally, we can compute the idea for distribution value of the term in the source language by the log of number of documents in the collection plus one divided by all the estimation in the second fragment. And let's replace the second formula to the third formula. If we replace that, we have this, which is the idea of the query, the source language, computed by log of number of documents in the collection plus one, divided by some multiplication between the translation and document frequency. As you can see in this formula, the probability of translation and also the document frequency of the term, both of them are in the denominator. And let's increase the document frequency of one of these translations. And if we increase the document frequency of the term, obviously the idea for this distinguishing value of query term in the source language also should increase, which is correct in this model. But if we decrease the quality of translation, means that this term is less important for us. But this term has more effect in the distribution value of query term. And by decreasing the quality of translation, the document the distribution value of query term increases, which is required in this model. So in this paper, we show that the PSQ has two pieces. The first one, the bad estimation for document frequency of query term based on information that we have in the target language. And the second one is that in the big corpus, PSQ allows that high frequency translation, even they have low translation probability, they have a lot of effect in the distribution value of query term. Based on these weaknesses, we proposed another model, which name is PSQ++. And in this model, instead of using the document frequency of the translation, we directly used the idea of the translation in the PSQ. And then we use the summation over the multiplication between the probability of translation and the idea. We use three data collection in our model. The first data collection has two courses in French and Italian language, and for each course we have 50 queries. We compare PSQ and PSQ Plus in these collections, and into measure map mean average precision of 10. And we show that the estimation that we have in the PSQ Plus can mean average precision up to 22% related. This can show that the estimation of the distribution value of query term in the CLI has a lot of effect on the performance of the CLI. As a conclusion, we show that the PSQ, we show that the document frequency of determining the target line in the source language the PSQ has some issues that hinder the performance of the CLI. And then we propose a new model to estimate this statistic for CLI. We use this model in the PSQ and we show that this can increase the performance of the CLI. And as a future work, we can compare PSQ and PSQ Plus in an axiomatic framework, which is an important framework in the information retrieval. And we also show that the correct estimation of the document frequency in the CLI can increase and have a great impact on the CLI performance. So as a future work, we can estimate more precisely this statistic in the CLI and then use them in the CLI models. Thank you for listening. I will be happy if you have a question to the session.